Welcome back to Evil Dead Regeneration. Time to finish up the game and face off with Reinhardt. There's nothing else to say, really. Time to fight Reinhardt. We could look at the extras, but we'll do that afterwards. Now do I remember how to fight him? I better.
This is it. Reinhardt's lair. The final chapter. The last stand.
We made a hell of a duo, didn't we? Partner.
Yeah, what you said.
All right then. Now let's butcher this evil bastard.
Knock, knock.
Ash!
Impossible!
We should consider ourselves lucky, Runt. He could have set up shop in the House of Mirrors.
I underestimated you, Ash. And you too, Sam. How have you been, my little failed experiment? Still dead, I'm guessing?
Well, funny, you sadistic monster. Why don't you... go hump a stump!
Maybe you should let me handle the witty banter, okay?
There's no way to stop the Necronomicon! Its power courses through my flesh! You've both come such an awfully long way to die! And the Neogor is not true.
Got time for one more session, Doc? I'm ready to resolve my anger issues.
Hey, you gotta give it to Sam. At least he tried. Let's not have that equipped. Let's go for the chainsaw. None of that, sir. Dab, 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 dab. You gotta keep dodging, RPG. Fortunately for us, Reinhardt is not a fighter. He's smart. He has the entire power of the Necronomicon behind him. And that was the wrong dodge. But he's not a fighter. Again, he has the power of the Necronomicon behind him. If you... dodge wrong timing. If you... don't kick Sam onto the Necronomicon, he will regenerate. And considering he has a... ton of life, it's probably a terrible idea. And if I could dodge properly, we'd be all set. Also, you can't hit him while he's doing that. Pretty much, Boom Lance is your only option of dealing enough damage. But other than that, it's just this. Again, Reinhardt is not a fighter. Unfortunately for us, Necronomicon power behind him. Please, continue fighting Sam. Fight the guy who's essentially immortal. It's not a good idea on your part, Reinhardt. Oh yeah, he gets slower as he gets closer to death. Oh, no, he died.
When you get to hell, tell him Ash sent you.
Manifestus Venethicum! Singi, Everisabilis, Malice.
Oh, Ash, you came for me. And I think you just saved the planet.
2 years you tortured me. Who's good? No! Did die? I mean, I'm good too, but still you... Get jack off!
Sally, I fought some crazy odds and came a very long way to tell you something.
Yes?
I just wanted to, well, apologize for the fashion advice I gave you back at Sunny Meadows.
How about this?
Oh, I'd forgotten you'd even said that. Until now.
Telegram from Sam!
Let's dance.
Cute. I was kind of expecting a girl who showed off a little more, you know, va-va-voom.
So I might have lied a little bit when I said that this game replaces Army of Darkness. Army of Darkness could still happen, just, you know... Well, we'd be missing a car, but... details. Nah, who cares about minor details like the car? I mean, it's not like it had a chemistry book in it, and, you know, shells, and... all whatever else was in it. Yeah, just Sam would have to be sent to a different place, and the car would have to magically be there or something. But there's also the thing that I haven't even thought of until recently. It's entirely possible that the human sacrifice actually ended up being Reinhardt. I mean, think about it. It was the whole... He didn't actually get to sacrifice Sally. And maybe the fact that Sally wasn't possessed very long, she didn't get much about that. I'm just saying. You know? I'm just saying. So, after doing Fistful of Boomstick and this over again, I feel very good about that. You know, having them not... in crapovision, basically. But pretty much this is the state, the last, you know, game of... Evil Dead that really means anything. I mean, there's a tower defense kind of game, there's some mobile games, but yeah, I'm talking about a real game. You know, not to say too many bad things about casual games. I play a few occasionally, or, you know, have them as a background application to distract me while I'm editing video, and I drop my controller. You know what I mean? It's just... I'm talking about, like, a real... Like, something like this, or Boomstick. I don't know, maybe because of the TV show, we'll see one of Ash in his old age. We can hope. You know, the Evil Dead fans can hope. You know, Evil Dead fans that happen to be gamers. Or gamers that happen to be Evil Dead fans. Whichever way it works for you. I still like Fistful of Boomstick more. Like, on the whole, aesthetically, this game is much better. I mean, I can't really argue that. To argue that would be stupid. This game does look better. I mean, it's a couple of years newer. I mean, it's kind of to be expected. and just a little bit creepy. Just a little bit. So I don't think I have anything really substantial to say at this point about the game. I think me playing it twice pretty much explains how I feel about the game. And, you know, being willing to do that. Extra time! We're gonna skip the credits because, nah, do we really care about games that came out 15 years ago, or whatever it was?
I did a film with Matthew Perry called Serving Sarah. The hilarious Serving Sarah. And we were walking to the set and he goes, you know, that Evil Dead game sucks. I went, oh, wait a second. First of all, stop right there. I didn't even know you played this game. He goes, yeah, I got the game. And so I keep talking. I go, so did you get all the way through the game? He goes, well, no. I went, well, that's interesting, Matthew. Maybe it's not the game that sucks. Maybe you suck. And he went into rehab the next day. So these games are very powerful.
Now, if he's talking about the Atari one, that's fine. Or the anyway. I think that's a worthy extra. Other than that, just, you know, a bunch of art. You notice the flicker? Time to come clean. The movies that you've been watching were actually from a YouTube video that I ripped off. I just recorded the whole, like, 48 minutes of cutscenes and inserted them instead of mine because I've had a lot of flickering and I can't figure out what's wrong with it. And it got to the point where it's like, you know what? It'll be easier if I just look it up on YouTube, screen capture someone, that movie uploaded, they showed all the, cinematics, I just put those in. It's a little extra step, but I figured it was worth it.
This particular game, we have the introduction of a new character, Sam. And he's a little runt, and he's a demon. He's a deadite. So, obviously, Ash and Sam don't really see eye to eye, because Ash is 4 feet taller. But philosophically, they don't either, because one is dead and one is alive. But Sam is pretty handy, because you can get that witty banter going. The good cop, bad cop. You're an idiot. No, you're an idiot. So it's like 48 hours with a chainsaw.
Exactly. And again, like I said earlier, it seems like it would be a little bit odd, but it actually does work.
Sam provides the opportunity for Ash not only to torment and punish him, is he can use him as a guinea pig. Of like, you go in there, you're already dead, get in there and check it out. So he's a very handy tool for the gamer. Because the solitary thing can get old after a while, because you got Ash walking around going, a box of shells, But at least now you can go, hey Sam, what is that? A box of shells, you idiot. See how useful that was?
Amazing. So yeah, that... After that, I have nothing really much to say. Oh, boy. Yeah, again, I'm sorry about the flickering. I can't figure out why it's doing it. And I can't find anybody showing the extras that it's not like this, so...
I've even done a video game, a voice for a video game, that never came out because by the time we were done, it was a completely outmoded platform. They were like, we don't do that anymore. Bye. I went, well, that was a waste of recording. But you just do what you can. So hopefully this one will be groovalicious.
And here we are in 2017, playing it again.
You know, I'll bet you'd be some kind of knockout if you traded in the grannyware for a bra that pushed up your yams. You know, I'll bet you'd be some kind of a knockout if you traded in the grannyware for a bra that pushed up your tatas. How insensitive.
that being one of the lines that, you know, that must have taken a few attempts to, you know, do it seriously.
Okay. No, no, yeah, I talk a little more like that. Okay. I understand. Yeah, Stark! You're looking a little unsightly.
Huh?
Is he too, too fruitcakey, or is he okay there? He's talking about me, hero. Okay. Bad first impression. reality check.
That's it. We are there. That's it.
Okay, fine.
Let me interrupt your really good take to, you know, tell you that's what I want.
Since the 25th anniversary of Evil Dead is coming up, which is shocking and horrifying at the same time, beautiful yet horrifying, the plan is to attempt some form of documentary of, like, where are they now? So there's, I think it'll be some fun clips of some of the actresses who really were the scream queens. They're soccer moms now. So, you know, Ellen Sandweiss, who was raped by a tree, her kids are, you know, regular old kids going to school.
Did they ever make that? You know, I'm a fan of the movies. I don't really consume too much of the, you know, documentary stuff. Which is weird. You'd think I'd be all over that, but eh.
It's kind of the fundamental difference between the Evil Dead series and, you know, Nightmare on Elm Street and Friday the 13th, that there's only one good guy, and that's Ash. All the other heroes who have endured for some reason are the bad guys, so maybe it's time for Ash to kick their little butts.
Yeah, he'd win anyway. We don't even need to see it. But, you know, maybe that's my fandom talking. Who, out of these lists of fictional characters, would win in a fight? Oh, my favorite would. It's a silly argument. It is. And some of it's really bad, too. Like, people get really intense. It's like, it's a fictional character. Who cares? From two different universes. Eh?
The rumor of Jason versus Freddy versus Ash is currently a pretty hot one. That one's buzzing around the internet. It's tearing it up on the internet. And that rumor, I have to say, is partially true. But you got to look at it this way. There's three franchises. So you got three batches of lawyers going, arr. So right now they're sort of yelling at each other, going, no, we're worth more. No, you suck. We're better. We're the better franchise. I guess I could just say this. They're in discussions right now. They're also trying to, you know, have peace in the Middle East, too. You usually get a script about that thick for video games because you have to be electrocuted. You have to, by death by strangulation, you fall off a cliff. So you have to record all the ways that you would die in the event that you would die that way. So there's a lot stored up. So if you ever want to hear the really fun stuff with these video games, just go into a corner and do something stupid for about 10 minutes, and you'll get yelled at.
Still haven't tried that. I really haven't. I'd rather play through the game. There should have been a section like that. Sam's rowing, and Ash is boomsticking things. Maybe I'm just being greedy. I might be.
It's interesting. Regular voiceover sessions, you show up, you do your thing, next on Fox, you know, and then you're out of there. With video games, it's weird because you have to record extra stuff that the gamer might never even do. Like, if he just goes up to a window and goes... Eventually... You know, Ash will say, there's nothing there.
I can only imagine how much audio I've never heard from this game.
I'm finally going to direct my first film, a tender love story called Man with the Screaming Brain. You know, the apple doesn't fall far from the tree. About a businessman who winds up being a guinea pig for a horrible experiment over in Europe. So we're going to shoot that in Bulgaria. That's where they shoot movies now. Because New Zealand is full. They're done. So now we're in Bulgaria. We'll be in Bratislava next. I don't know. And in your backyard after that.
I am still waiting.
Do you know how many germs these rats are packing? Syphilis, polio, rabies, gingivitis, little petri dishes with fur teeth for freak's sake. I'd rather suck face with a sewage pipe with tongue than either be in the same zip code as one of his disease-ridden master types.
In case you couldn't quite hear it, because at the time Ash and Professor Nobi were having a gab session.
The truth to the rumor of evil dead boar. Well, the real trick there is to call Sam Raimi on the phone and convince him to do Evil Dead 4 instead of Spider-Man 2. Well, that's a tough one. Sam, I hope you'll be able to make that decision.
Yeah, and we all know how that turned out. Although we did get a TV show, to be fair. We did.
In the first Spider-Man, as you recall, I named the character. Without my character in the movie, without the ring announcer, that movie would have been called The Human Spider. Let's just get it out there, okay? In part two, I can't tell you much for legal reasons. My character defeats Spider-Man. Sam, I didn't say any more. See? It's pretty good. He defeats Spider-Man. Wow. Part three, I become Spider-Man. Because Toby ain't gonna do it.
And that's it. Those are all 20 extras. So anyway, I hope you've enjoyed a dose of Evil Dead. And hopefully we get more games because of the TV show. That'd be nice. I can hope. Like a real game. Like, you know, again, mobile game, that's fine and everything. But give us, you know, redone Boomstick. And, make it bigger. Make it better. Or remake this. I don't really want a remake. I would like something new. But at the same time, I wouldn't complain too much, and I'd probably still buy it, so I don't know. Anyway, next time, something else. Until then.